Driving along our roadways, you'll see many different types of products designed to provide proper roadway guidance. There are reflectors, signs, rumble strips, and even speed bumps. But the most common type of marking you'll see is the striping that divides our roadways and keeps drivers aware of where they need to be and where they don't. But there's much more to striping than meets the eye. Most striping in the U.S. consists of a white or yellow waterborne paint that is required to meet state and federal specifications. As it is sprayed, glass beads are added as a reflective top coat to help with visibility at night. It's a low-temperature, quick-drying solution for striping while the roadway is still in use. And while waterborne traffic paint is the most common product used for roadway markings, the striping material seen here is a thermoplastic product. It begins as a powder which is melted down in a kettle at about 200 degrees Celsius, where it reaches a molten state. In this instance, the material is loaded onto a mobile unit and is applied by the operator onto the pavement surface at the prescribed location based on the roadway design. It quickly cools into a solid marking, which adheres to the roadway and should last several years. Glass beads are also added to the thermoplastic paint as it is applied. The reflectivity of these markings is tested periodically, and the striping must be corrected if it falls below a specified value. Keeping motorists heading in the right direction with effective roadway guidance is an important part of our transportation infrastructure. Now you know.